Hey everyone, and welcome to another Hungover Gaming Overwatch replay. I'm Yvonne, and I'll be your host for today's match on Nepal. Now, if you haven't watched an Overwatch replay before, this is a competitive Overwatch match that my buddy Julian and I play together, and we'll be commentating over to give the tips, tricks, and all of the hints that you need to get out of ELO Hell. Now, I am playing Zarya to begin with, and Julian's playing Mei, and we've got a team with Mercy, Ana, Soldier, and a Torbjorn to start out with. And on this map on Nepal, you really want to push to the shrine if you can to get there first. If you can't, you want to flank around and make sure that you have enough firepower to get through. Julian and I team up to get through the front of it, while Soldier and Mercy team up around the flank, and that's able to split up the enemy team enough, and with the help of Torbjorn's turret pushing them off the other places, we're able to get them off and get the point before they can even snag it. And we're making sure to communicate on team chat to make sure that everyone knows that Soldier is going around, etc. Now, what gets really interesting here is that Zenyatta sitting up top there, he really never gets pressured. Our Soldier never pushes him off of there, and he gets to put in a lot of Discord orbs and send in a bunch of shots from the top up there. Their Reinhardt is also pretty zealous and loves to go for the pin, and as I drop down there to try and sneak around, get some damage, and build up my power gauge, as Zarya, I'm able to tempt out a few different things. Now, that Reinhardt is, we're trying to punish him on the one side, and trying to group around on the other side. I focus the D.Va, because I know that with Zarya's beam, you can take her out without being blocked, and I get blocked there by Julian instead. There's a Bastion down here. It would have been better for him to put the wall in front of that Bastion. Instead, I try to charge him like the Light Brigade, and I go down, but thankfully Mercy rezzes me, and we're able to push and win this team fight because of that rez and because of our teamwork. Roadhog goes down, and everyone's trickling in. You can see that I'm getting Discord and targeted by Zenny from that roof, but Soldier's not going to go over there and get him, and he's putting some pressure, but not enough to really worry about, I guess. But there's that Zenny coming around again. There's a D.Va that goes around on the other side. I want to chase the D.Va here, but I also don't want to leave the center too much. I don't want to drop down. I don't want to limit my mobility. So I'm really trying to focus on this area and staying close to the team. I hear the Transcendence go off, and I really want to be close to him. What's interesting about the enemy team is they don't coordinate the Transcendence that well with the rest of the team. And the sound barrier could have been dropped a little bit later, but gives Soldier enough time that he survives my initial blast. I drop my ult there kind of to pin Soldier in one spot so he can't go around and kill the entire team, which was maybe not the best strategy, but at least it went off and we win the round. So here we go, continuing on. Getting our cool hero poses. As you can see, the team has pretty much stayed exactly the same way it was, and now we're on the map where you need to be able to hold the area that's pretty covered. I'm following the Soldier and the Mercy as they rush out. We're trying to get to a point where we can put pressure on the enemy team as they come out. The enemy team went to the opposite side that we did, funnily enough, and now we're getting pressured. Torbjorn's running on top to try and find a place to put his turret, and I'm trying to poke in, poke out, and flank what I can do, but then I have to drop back, start putting defensive barriers onto my team, flank around, try and distract them. Julian and I are trying to contest as much as we can here so that we can stop them from getting the point so easily, but to no avail. They kill us in a 3-on-6, and it's not great. So now we're trying to regroup, but as happens a lot, we get pushed a little too early. Mercy tries to get up to where the Torbjorn is, I'm guessing, and gets taken out before that could happen. So now we have a 5-on-6. If we can get a pick, maybe we'll even it up, we'll be better at it. We get the pick on the Mei, and we're ready to go, we're ready to push, and then their Mercy rezzes. So we're now even strength. But we can get the pick on Reinhardt, we can go in, we can charge. And I'm trying to now focus that Mercy. I don't want her to Lay on the healing. She has used her res, but I'm still always worried when there's an enemy Mercy around because of the amount of healing and damage boost that she can provide. Probably should have gone for someone else, and Ana drops, I think, what was a panic ult right on me. So I'm stuck in the blizzard, there's no way I can do anything, and she wastes her ult. So now we've lost that push onto the point, and we're not really grouped together in terms of our deaths, and we're one less ult. So I tried to take out that soldier. The Reinhardt gets slept. I should have let him stay slept and focused on the Mercy. The soldier comes in, but what's really critical, as you can see on the left, we have a teammate leave, and now it's a 5-on-6 battle. And even with this tactical visor, I probably should have put a shield on. I'm trying to separate here on the backside to single out that Mercy. I get her, but not really able to pressure the rest of the team, and in the 5-on-6. Now it's a 5-on-5, and then we keep losing. That Reinhardt does a lot of work there, and we're down. There's no way we're coming back from that, and we lose the point. So you can see there, I have silver in eliminations and in damage done, which is good for me, but I don't think it's great for our team in general because we need a little bit more damage output. Now we have Soldier, Mei, and Torbjorn as our damage dealers, which could be better. We have only got Mia's tank and Ana as our healer. Now Julian switches out from Mei to D.Va, which I think is a great switch. Puts a lot more pressure in terms of straight damage, and some of the defensive mobility able to suck up some damage. Mei can do that a lot as well, but luckily, you know, we can work together and coordinate with Julian in terms of my ult and his blast. There I see that Zenyatta gets a little bit uncovered by that Reinhardt. I think I could sneak in, just kill her, the Zenyatta, and move on. But I get caught, and I'm not able to get to the health back. Now I'm rushing back, and I see that that soldier, that very same soldier that killed me, gets alone. You're not able to flank and kill him, or not flank, but kill him as I'm rushing back. Now I'm trying to poke out, keep enough of my health together. I got really saved there by that Mercy and by Julian's D.Va. Again, that's the second time I think I put down a shield and it's either gone away or not gone through. But we're able to put a lot of damage on. Now our Ana has become a Pharah and then a McCree. So it's an interesting switch, and our Mercy's back, so we're back down to one healer. We should have three damage dealers, so we should be able to put in a lot of work in terms of killing. And we've got D.Va and myself to do a lot of blocking, but as you can see, we're not dropping them fast enough. I should have been able to provide a shield there and do some protective stuff, but I'm really trying to focus on this Reinhardt. I hear the Junkrat thing go off, and I know I'm dead. I could have dropped my ult there, but I don't, because that's a panic ult. You want to avoid dropping a panic ult as much as possible, even though dropping the Zarya ult into that little tight space is really good when they can't be shielded by Reinhardt. But being shielded by Reinhardt, it's hard to do different things. I'm able to get out of the way. I protected someone from the Reinhardt ult, but not the soldier. I have to put this ult on so that we can kill someone on the point. The Blizzard is a counter ult, kind of, as well as the Zenyatta ult. So now it's a battle of who can outlast the other one. We're doing pretty well here, thanks to my shields, some damage from Mercy, etc. I get trapped here, and that's the end of me. When I get trapped, I'm not able to get off of the point, and we get killed. Julian switched off of D.Va to Roadhog there because he probably wasn't able to get enough healing done for himself. Roadhog can heal themselves, and that hook also provides a lot of easy access for damage for other people. So Roadhog is also good when you're stuck in Elo Hell and you want to go single or kind of single and the team isn't grouping up. So that's, I think, the process there. And I'm going to stick with Zarya because I was boneheaded, and I think provides a good defensive boost. And now that I see that Torbjorn turret there, I really want to stay with Zarya. So we get a little split up in terms of our team positioning there, and they're able to take out Julian. But I love the fact that there's a Torbjorn turret and I'm playing Zarya. I can use my shield to prevent getting damaged by the turret and also boost up my damage output at the same time. Here I'm poking in, probably a little too far considering that's where that turret placement is. I'm really trying to get that Lucio. He was down to one shot. I didn't have enough support. The team was rushing back but couldn't get there, or the people who were around just weren't ready for that push. So there we go. But after that push goes through, I'm able to get back to the point as my team has done all the work to capture it. So I'll just be sitting here in the glory with everyone else, and we're able to even pick off some retreating people like Mei. Now here this Lucio pushes way too far out. We punish him for it tremendously, and the rest of the team is there now, but down one healer, and that Mei has been downed. Now as you can see, I'm taking damage from the turret, of course, but that Zenyatta has gone back to the upright point, and that can be very dangerous for me because I can get the Discord Orb, which can shred tanks, or any other character, but really tanks because their hitboxes are so large. So here we go, rushing back to the point. We haven't really taken too much. I see this Mei, she blocked me off, so I'm going to not chase after her too much. I'm going to really push on, try and save the rest of the people. Save that soldier from being frozen. Go after the Lucio, I'm able to knock him down. And even though that soldier charges into that blizzard ult as fast as he can, able to keep him alive. That Mercy goes down, nothing I can do there. I was already trying to save the soldier. And that soldier ult is able to do a lot of damage. And because he has the orb, I'm not able to finally kill him. I get really destroyed by the amount of team damage they're placing onto this point, and that's just too much for me. But three of us are down, we all get rezzed, but again, I just get destroyed by two alts there, so I can't do a lot to save myself or the team at that point. Really depending on us getting a good group. We have a significant percentage advantage, so we can use a little bit of that cushioning as they're getting closer to our point. And here I see the Mei, and eventually, because of that Mercy, we're able to join together, kill that Mei. I can put my ult onto the point. We shred this Reinhardt shield and he goes away anyway, but we're also able to focus the people behind him, get that Lucio, get the Torbjorn. By the time Zenny comes back, Reinhardt comes back, we're really ready to handle them. I'm going to focus on this Reinhardt, the other tank, and I get behind his shield as much as possible. He gets stunned. That Mei is about to drop an ult and it stops our soldier because he's dropped his ult as well. But she fails to kill him, especially because of the Torbjorn turret, so we're able to push them off. Their soldier goes with his, but he's solo ulting by himself, and that leads to pretty much no gain. So we're able to really kill those people who are trickling in, and that's good for our team. We recap the point, stop them from getting it to 100, and but punishing the people who are stuck in those waves, trying to get to the point and save the team. Here, if I was them, I'd try and group up a little bit more, but there's not a lot you can do when it's overtime and you're trickling in this way. It's very difficult to get together. I'd try and get at least two or three people together before going in, but they're not able to. Here we go, into the final round. It's 2-2. What can happen? Well, a lot can happen, and especially if the team comp is a little awkward, but this is the one that we can go with. We have three tanks, it's a strong meta, plus a soldier and a McCree backing them up. We should be able to focus fire, kill a lot of people, use the Reinhardt shield and my shields as barriers, and really focus and kill anything that comes in our path. So here we go, let's check it out. Now, my teammates were telling me they wanted to push up on this left side, so I'm following Julian up there. He gets pinned, misses the hook, but and I was out of shield at the moment, so I couldn't have done anything. with this maze coming out, we're able to focus her. That Reinhardt got picked off because he was away from his team. His entire team didn't go in the columns as opposed to ours, so we're able to get the objective, and now we're just going to hold it. I'm going to poke out, see what I can do, maybe build some alt charge and build mine and power output at the same time. If you saw in a previous video, I actually poked out too much and I died coming around that corner, so I've learned not to go out and kill myself. But here I'm trying to stick close to the Reinhardt. There's a Bastion that's putting a lot of damage on, so I try to poke out with my shield. I don't get trapped here as I did earlier in the video, but I do get the death grenade almost. I need healing. I'm calling out in team chat that I need healing, and thankfully that soldier drops his health pack. The other great thing is that with Zarya, the shields regenerate a lot. Now, I had thought that the Reinhardt had been shielded and would be able to take out the enemy Reinhardt, so I didn't expect a ult coming from behind me, focused on the Bastion and the Zenyatta, and not that I was doing damage to him anyway, and we got destroyed from the back there. Now this Reinhardt was poking out by himself a lot because he had been killed earlier in the wave of deaths, and it wasn't doing him a lot. His barrier's damaged a lot here. His health is lower. I'm able to thankfully push out more and recharge my power output, get it up to 100%. I'm able to stop that junk rat thing. And so here we're really trying to pull together. The soldier goes off, so I'm going to focus him. I have my shield up. I'm able to put enough damage on him. He goes down. So there I have three alts that have gone off there. With the Transcendence, the Junk Tire, and Soldier, I think here's where we have our push. We have the alt advantage, we have everything, so I'm trying to build up my damage output a little bit greedily there. Almost died, thankfully the Mercy was with me, and we're trying to flank and push out at the same time. I want to keep that Soldier off. I scare him so much he kills himself, and here we can focus. That Bastion pulls a panic alt, and then we kill all three of them. Team kill there, and really trying hard to remember how to.
2 hours later.
So here we go. We have a really strong push to get this point. I'm trying to poke out, build my charge, and build my power. This Lucio brings in enough wiliness that nobody can really hook him well, and I don't know what happened. It's just. Our team is getting pushed around over here. Even though that Reinhardt fails, it's this Lucio's bouncing around me. There's a Bastion somewhere around here. I'm getting destroyed, and then I get pinned because I'm trying to focus that Lucio. I get him down, but I get pinned. And there it is. 5 of our team goes down. It's hard to imagine how quickly things can fall apart here in Overwatch, but it's you turn around trying to follow this wily Lucio, and everybody goes down. So here we are. We're trying to group up for our last push. I'm following this Reinhardt, hoping that he goes down the middle. And I go, and I get trapped, and then I get shredded. Now that's a place that I love to put the trap as a Junkrat myself, so I felt so noobish getting caught there. But we're going to push in. We get enough kills thanks to the res to bring us back into the point where we can get the point again. I didn't even realize I had a Reaper, but somebody must have switched at some point. So now we're just facing this soldier teamed up with the Zenyatta. The thing is that is a really high damage output team, and it takes out Julian incredibly quickly. They have a Zenyatta ult able to maintain and dilute any damage I'm putting on them. I'm at 20% health. I'm at 4% health. I'm gonna die. I tried to push out as much as I could, but I couldn't do anything. Julian's trying to get back, as that switch to Winston will tell you, and to no avail. We go down. So that was it. It was a tough loss. We tried our best, but we couldn't get through it. So that was our Overwatch replay, and I got the play of the match. Check it out. It's the part where I do the thing. Thank you for watching this video so much to the end, if you're still with me. We do Overwatch replays every Wednesday at 9 a.m. And then on Monday, we also have a podcast where we talk about all sorts of different topics, including gaming. That also comes out at 9 a.m. And on Fridays, we do a drunk Let's Play with all sorts of different games. So thank you, everyone. Have a great day. And check out these other videos that we have if you like this one. Toodaloo.